guys, what is going on? It's Scottish Ghost here once again, and we've got something a little bit different for you guys. We have my second squad builder from the channel. Now, this is my current squad. I'll actually play this in a different formation, but this one's probably better for, you know, positioning maybe. So yeah, first off, in goals, we have none other than Casillas. Now, obviously, he is amazing. He's got really good stats for a goalkeeper, maybe lacking a bit on the kick-in wise, but he's actually a very, very decent goalkeeper. 6-1, acrobatic, and he's only played one game. This is a very recent squad. I only bought it maybe 4 days ago. So yeah, that's Casillas, got about 4k, which is not too bad, I guess. Two centre-backs we've got Godin, and we've got Miranda or Pepe, it doesn't really matter, but I like Miranda better. He's got a red card, as you can see, but these guys, oh, they are very, very solid centre-backs. They've been very good for me, like, massively, they've been very good. Pepe's just as good as them, but I just prefer Miranda. I think I'm right. I think he's just a bit more, you know, up to scratch. 6'1", he's pretty tall as well, and he's just got a good all-round stats for defending, obviously. He's played 13 games for me, so pretty decent. Left back, we have got Fabio Contral. I am looking to get Jordi Alba for that position. I'm not conscious of that just now, but yeah, he's not bad, I guess. Obviously, he has got the pace, really. He's got good all-round stats, so 79 dribbling, 80 pace, 75 defence, 76 physical, which is pretty decent, and he 5'10", which is not too bad at all. Right back, we have got Juanfran. Now, he is actually, I think he's underrated. I really do think he's underrated, because he's got good stats, 82 pace, 78 physical, 76 defence, and good dribbling as well, and he has got high medium work rate, which is pretty decent for a right back, and only 1.2k, which is pretty decent, I have to admit. So move on to the midfield here, and we've got none other than Rodriguez and Xavi. Now, where is that? These guys, they are very, very decent. I think Rodriguez is better because obviously he's got more pace than Xavi, quite a lot more. He's only like 66 or 80. But Xavi is obviously a lot more of a playmaker. He is very, like, a lot more experienced as well. And they're both 86 rated, and that is very high. Obviously, he is very good at passing. That's just pretty much him, really. And obviously, Rodriguez has got a good all-round stats. 80 pace, 80 shooting, 84 passing, and 85 dribbling. And is very good at free kicks, and medium is pretty decent as well. There is an ice cream outside. I don't know if you can hear that. There's an ice cream shop outside. but anyways, Cam, we have got none other than Isco. He's pretty decent for Cam, I have to admit. Not the best pace. 77 pace is not too bad, I guess, but he could be doing a little bit more, maybe 80, 81, but he's actually not too bad. 77 shooting, 84 passing, 87 dribbling, and he's surprisingly, even though he's only 5'9" and 63 physical, he's actually quite strong on the ball when he doesn't get pushed off very often, and he has 4-star skills. Here we go, here are the bad boys up front. We have got, wait a minute, he's actually right mid. wait a minute now. There you go. It's none other than Gareth Bale. Now, yeah, in the last squad builder, I showed you Bale and my reserves. That's why I got him in an untradeable pack, and I was gutted. Honestly, I was very, very gutted. I think he was like 500k at the time. I don't know how much he is now, but honestly, I was very gutted. But I've Gareth Bale there. He's got bloody blistering pace. The only problem with him, right? He's got good stats, amazing stats, 83 shot, 83 passing, 84 dribbling, 81 physical. The only problem is with him, see his dribbling, it's just not good enough. Seriously, see when you try and pass it to him, he runs through the line, it only looks like he has about 80 pace. Seriously, but if you put him through ball, he'll just blast past Jordi Alba and all that, all the really fast left backs, and honestly, he's actually very, very quick, and obviously really good shoot, really good like finishing, and other amazing stats there. 87 rated, you can't really complain. Left mid here, left wing here, I'm looking to get Neymar, but he is quite a lot, but obviously the replacement for Neymar is none other than Pedro. he's actually, I think he's a good rating. I think he might be slightly overrated. Because I think in Pez, you know Pez 2015, I think he's only about 80 rated, so 83 rated, I don't know. We'll see what happens with him though. He's got 5 star rating, 4 star skills, and he is not really strong. That's the only problem with him really. Good pace, good dribbling, not bad shooting, and pretty good passing as well. I picked him up for, I think it was in a pack. I think he's only about what, 3k or something, I think he's even that. But yeah. Here we go guys, Benzema is the last player in our team. Bang! What can I say? What can I say about this team? Benzema just like finishes it off really. 84 pace, 84 shooting, 82 dribbling, and good physical and pretty good passing as well. 4 star skills, 4 star weak foot, and I bought him for 6.4k, which is pretty decent. And he's just been sick, he's been very good for me. 6 goals in 8 games, which is not too bad I guess. I'm not very good at scoring really, as you've probably seen my manager here. yeah, it's pretty decent. So that is the team guys. I have got a couple of the Spanish kind of scent. I was using Rodrigo until I got Benzema. He is pretty decent. He's a good starting off kind of centre forward for your Spanish team. I think I got him in a undrivable pack as well actually. He's got 86 pace, pretty decent shooting, and dribbling. He's pretty good starting off. He's kind of like Benzema, but just not as good at all. Not as clinical. Bojan here, he's got 4 star skills, yeah. He's just pretty decent. He's plays for Stoke, he's actually right. 82 pace, 86 dribbling, 76 shooting, pretty good passing, and very, very weak, which is the only problem. And a few other players like Ilaramendi, Petty, and quite a few other guys there. Christian Tello as well, I don't really play with him very much. Montanes, Rakitic, I sub for Esco sometimes. I had him, he's an untradeable pack. This team, literally, and half the team is from untradeable packs, seriously. And then I was like, ah, stuff this, I'm going to change it, because I had a BPL team, and I've actually sold it. But then I got this team, which is pretty decent. So thanks so much for watching guys. If you want any more squad builders, let me know. I will try and do them as fast as possible really. Yeah, hopefully I'll try and do some more FIFA videos. Hopefully this is a change from manager career, because I've done quite a lot of that recently. So yeah, just a little change on things for my channel, try and mix it up a wee bit. But yeah, I think it's a pretty solid team and I do very well with it. So thanks so much for watching, hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you all later.